This is an RTX 3050. It is an Eagle variant sent over by Gigabyte, and it is the loseriest RTX graphics card that you can buy today, which made me think, I wonder if the loseriest RTX graphics card can do the hardest RTX thing. So let's see what it takes to get this RTX 3050 to do some ray tracing. That is a nice futuristic looking eye on the box. Ooh, it's quite little. Look at that. The whole card is just covered in this film of plastic. Oh yeah, there we go. That is a very interesting paint finish on the card. I actually really like it. It's kind of like a matte gray. It's definitely plastic, but you know, it is a relatively budget card. I mean, you know, it's 2022, so this is probably still gonna sell for $8,000 on the used market. But yeah, it's a pretty good looking little card. Let's have a quick look at the specs of the new baby RTX graphics card. The render config looks like this, and as you can see, it's got less GPU stuff in it than the previous runt of the RTX litter, the 2060. Interestingly, the RTX 3050 has more video memory, running 8 gigs of GDDR6 as opposed to 6 gigs of GDDR6, although the memory bus is a bit smaller at 128-bit as opposed to 192-bit on the 2060. And according to Tech Power-Up's GPU tier list, these hardware changes means that the RTX 3050 lags about 16% behind its beefier big brother. With that, there's just one more quick thing we have to have a look at before we throw the 3050 into the ray-traced gauntlet. As is tradition on this channel, every time we have a graphics card, we have to take it apart and see what's going on underneath the cooler. Instead of a warranty void sticker, they have a Gigabyte qualified sticker, which, does that mean it will or won't catch on fire? I've been screwing for a while, and this screw isn't coming undone. The screw is fine. So I think it's like a thread issue in the plastic. Because I can't get that screw undone. The one has come undone, but it... Oh! Okay, that just kind of popped out like that. Yeah, unfortunately, you can't really see in there, but there was... definitely some kind of threading issue going on there. You can actually see some unconsensual plastic debris still left on the screw. Anyway, here is the bottom of the cooler, which is a pretty standard lower end graphics card cooler. You've got a single heat pipe going through that actually makes direct contact with the die, and then you've got a whole bunch of thermal pad all over the place. It seems like Gigabyte is so scared of getting roasted for incomplete thermal pad coverage that they added thermal pads to spots where there are no modules for the pads to contact, but you know, that's going above and beyond, I guess. And here is the bare PCB, which, as you can see, there's a whole bunch of space for higher end versions of this Eagle card. There's even additional sets of solder points for more fans and RGB and stuff, so yeah, you can scale this PCB up. But yeah, with that, let's actually clean off the thermal paste and have a closer look at an RTX 3050 die. And there is quite a thick die for a 50 series card. It's a pretty big GPU. With that, let's put it back together and get into some ray tracing. Okay, now we're starting off with Quake 2, which I think may be the easiest game to run with ray tracing, if I'm not mistaken. We're currently running with it in OpenGL, and you can see that we're steadily running at 1,000 frames per second. This is the smoothest thing I have ever seen. Oh, there's a man. It looks very different now. It's much brighter, actually. Like, the environment is much better lit. And we've lost a whole bunch of frame rates, but it's still running well. I think it would have been a really bad start if this didn't run. That would not have been a good sign at all. But it's running fine. But with that, let's try something a bit more modern. I found that control's performance seems to not suffer that much when ray tracing is enabled. Although, it's not super promising to start off with, because here, it's running just at high settings at 1080p with no ray tracing, and we're hovering around 60 frames per second at the moment. Let's just go straight to high ray tracing. We're looking at just over half the frame rate we had before, and that's with nothing going on in the scene. We're not like fighting anyone or anything. It does not feel very good, but luckily we do have a secret weapon in terms of ray tracing. So let's see if turning on DLSS helps much. Ooh, that feels way better. And considering that normally control looks like it's rendered in a tub of Vaseline, it doesn't look much worse. Okay, it's time for the original poster boy of RTX. This is running at 1080p high settings. It feels good. This is nice. This is a very solid gaming experience. Yeah, so let's ruin it. Well, I mean, look, it's definitely reduced the frame rate, and I would not recommend running it with ray tracing, considering that I don't think I could really tell the difference straight off the bat. But it's working, you know. This is a very playable frame rate. Wow, okay, so let's see if we can push it harder. But okay, so it's all on ultra now as opposed to high. Oh, see, there's some fire on our gun. Yes, that's worth half the frame rate, definitely. Oh yes, my favorite disappointment, Cyberpunk. Here, 1080p, at medium-ish settings, we're getting about 60 frames per second. So it's very playable on this GPU. So let's just be brave initially and crank it to psycho. Hell yeah, let's see. Does it look better than it did before? Like maybe some of the lighting a little bit? I don't know. Let's get in a car and drive around. That usually completely breaks it. Oh yes, no, that is some primo gaming performance we've got right here. I have an idea. Let's try and enable DLSS. Maybe that helps a bit. Balanced. Oh, that's made it much better. Now, we're still sub 60 frames per second here, but at least the game doesn't feel like it's being played via dial-up anymore. Although, having said that, at this point, we haven't seen real performance carnage yet, so let's take it to the next level. Let's try Psycho Ray Tracing at 4K. Ah, there we go. That was more along the lines of what I was expecting in terms of gaming performance. Let's see if DLSS can save this nightmare. Oh, it still doesn't like that at all. Maybe ultra performance is better? So at the moment, we're running at 4K using Psycho Ray Tracing with ultra performance DLSS, which I think is probably one of the dumbest game settings you can run Cyberpunk in. Like, I don't think you can go dumber than that. But, I mean, it's kind of running. It looks pretty good, but I guess it's because the render resolution is essentially 1080p. Now, the final game that we obviously need to test is Turtle Simulator Remastered. Now, I actually read on my Google propaganda feed that it's been fixed. They've done a bunch of patches and it runs way better. So, yeah, let's also test that out here. Let me just get to a more sunny bit of the game, because for some reason it doesn't seem to have cloud saves. Okay, so at 1080p high settings, we are struggling to stay in 60 frames per second. It does touch it every now and then, but it does look very beautiful. Now I'm gonna start off with performance and just see how much of a difference that makes. But this is fine, this is perfectly playable, I think. It's a bit input laggy. Honestly, I actually wouldn't play it this way. Let's try very high. They may actually have fixed the performance here, because adding ray tracing hasn't had much of a negative effect. Although, let's try crank it. It's starting to struggle a little bit now, but still, it's kind of playable. Whether or not it looks better now than it did without ray tracing on, I guess is up for debate. Although, by looking at side-by-side footage, I think how they fixed the performance impact was just make the setting not do anything, because I can't tell a difference. That went pretty well. I was kind of expecting the graphics card to copiously soil itself, like a small child getting on stage for the first time in front of its hard-ass ray-traced parents. But that didn't happen. Although, that being said, there was still a reasonable performance impact with a lot of these games, and in a bunch of them, it was, you couldn't tell it was on. Like, in some of them, I genuinely thought that the settings didn't apply, but they did, you could tell, because it was running a lot slower. So even three-ish years after the initial introduction of ray tracing, it's still pretty dumb. So hopefully, 3 years from now, maybe it'll be better, I guess. At least, DLSS is quite nice. So yeah. That brings me to the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked the video, like and subscribe to the channel. We are very close to 400,000, so if you can help push us over that edge, that'll be really nice. Thank you. And yeah, until the next video, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.